It's May 24th and we're on the ground in Madia with a team from the Civil Defense Commission. They're conducting an assessment to see who or which of the residents need assistance after severe flooding hit this community.
The Civil Defense Commission mobilized the rapid response team within 3 hours and departed Georgetown. They were on the ground in Madia within 1 hour. The two-man team led by Captain Salim October liaised with town council officials. They then conducted an assessment at critical areas affected by flash flooding.
For one resident, Quincy Calder, the flooding is the worst he's seen in some 40 years.
The longtime resident was among those who helped to save an elderly neighbor, Felix Barker, who was trapped in his nearby low-lying home by rising floodwaters.
It was a sad situation because I had to leave my home, swim through this whole road, become a creek, to go into a home to save him until his grandson nearly drunk. I had to help the grandfather and the grandson. And it was not anything easy. If I didn't have courage and strength, it would have been a set of dead people this morning.
We also spoke to David Boyce, one of the mechanics in Madia. His home and business was also affected by flooding.
The 51-year-old opened his workshop 5 years ago. On May 24, he awoke around 5 a.m. to find his bed afloat.
We had to jump off and start grabbing things. Try to pick up some stuff, but we didn't get everything, plenty thing of it.
The floodwaters damaged not only his equipment, but those belonging to customers.
Welding set, engine parts, engine, generator, welding set, welding rod, you understand, rice flour, plenty things.
Boyce's workshop is also his home. It is a few meters away from one of Madia's many creeks.
If the creek widen and get a little deeper, it's supposed to have the problem. But it's not now, you know, this thing going on for a little while. But this time it was.
Several low-lying roads and trails were flooded with portions of some washed away. Some bridges over creeks suffered the same fate.
One of the bridges linking the Red Hole and White Hole area along the trail to Madia was washed away. We spoke to several of the truckers stranded on the other side, waiting to cross to get into Madia.
The truckers had to wait several hours for emergency repairs before being able to cross.
Before it happened right here, and they put in only one culvert, and the culvert is too small to take the volume of the water.
Minister of Public Infrastructure David Patterson said measures have been put in place to remedy the situation.
There have been some breaches on the road where we have machines right there right now fixing that particular section of the road that washed away, and that'll be fixed within the next 12 to 18 hours. Vehicles will continue using that, and then obviously we have a immediate emergency work which I have activated so that we will actually put a bridge over that section, because we're in May, the May-June rain, so obviously we expect another for the next 6 weeks you'd have rain. So we have a short-term immediate measure that is in place now, a emergency work which is a bridging to ensure that if the rains continue, even with that amount of intensity, it does not affect the communities being able to access their in and out of access to the community.
Minister Patterson was accompanied by his cabinet colleague, Minister of Natural Resources, Raphael Trotman. They flew into Madia with a team of engineers to get a first-hand look at the situation. The government will work with the Madia Town Council to put a sustainable plan in place.
It's fortunately, it's not as bad as it looked initially on the social media. It's not raining now, and we have bright sunshine. I mean, the water's off the land, but obviously what happened is that where the water traversed over the land, there's some issues which we are addressing now. So the good news is that we are okay now.
Flood-affected residents received cleanup kits and food hampers via the CDC. Captain Salim October said that the assessments proved that the seasonal flash flooding was not as bad as initially expected.
But what is important is that we were able to ensure that we understand the needs of the residents. As a consequence of that, we were prepared to establish any shelter arrangements or provide temporary relief through food supply should their need would have arise. But at this time, we were able to provide cleaning kits to ensure that families engage in a process of cleanup where cleanup was necessary. And we have hampers remaining in the region, food hampers, so that in case there is any repeat or there are other needs that may arise based on any other hazard impact that may impact the region, we are also prepared.
Madia's Mayor David Adams expressed appreciation for the CDC's rapid response.
You wouldn't believe that we had a flood yesterday. Right? That is the nature of the terrain. Right? The rain comes, it falls heavily, it floods, and then it washes out. Of course, there are some people who are affected. We're going to talk to them, encourage them to move from the affected area. We're going to speak to the Ministry of Housing in collaboration. We will work in collaboration with the Ministry of Housing, in fact, to have an area identified to which we can relocate them. Of course, it's up to them. Some of them have been attached to the area for a long time. But we're going to encourage them to make a move and occupy other areas in the area. All in all, though, I think it's a quick response, a good response from the CDC. And we're looking forward to their assistance in future.
If the rains continue, the Civil Defense Commission is prepared to put more resources into this area. From Majo, the capital town of Petaro, Ciparuni, with senior videographer Leon Leong, Paul McAdam for InfoHub.